A point is a position, and a vector describes a motion. We can combine points and vectors in various useful ways by adding or subtracting their coordinates from one another. To start with, if you subtract the location of point A from point B, you get a vector describing how to get from point A to B. So B minus A is calculated by taking the coordinates and subtracting them from one another, and this gives you vector V. The reverse also holds true. A plus V equals B. While we can subtract points to get a vector, our system doesn't produce anything geometrically meaningful if you add the two points together. We can also add and subtract vectors themselves. For example, S plus T equals U. We can also reverse this process. For example, U minus T equals S. And we can go the other way around. For example, U minus S equals T. One way to think about vector subtraction is that you're instead adding a vector going the opposite direction, as shown here. The other thing commonly done with vectors and points is to multiply them by a scalar, that is, a number. Multiplying a vector by a scalar is clear enough. You want to describe moving further in a given direction. If you multiply by -1, you reverse the vector's direction. Multiply by a different negative number, and you reverse the direction and change how far to move. Multiplying a point by a number is a way to make an object larger or smaller. This type of operation, called scaling, we'll discuss in detail later.